Hi, I'm Nastya from Tilda. In this video, I will show you how to create new sticker animation for product cards on your Tilda website. Let's delete all default elements in the new zero block and set up the artboard settings. First, change the grid container height to 740 pixels. Then, enable order scale and change the background color to gray. With auto scale enabled, the block adjusts automatically to match your browser's width. To learn more about setting up auto scale, check out the link in the description. Now let's have a look at the layout. Here we have two product cards, and we're going to start with a dark one. Add a rectangle by clicking on Add New Shape, set its width to 570 pixels and its height to 610 pixels. Change the color to a darker one and place it to the right. Let's create a new sticker animation effect. First, add a text element, set its size to 200 pixels, and change its color to match the background. You can do it by using a color picker in a color tab. Now let's edit the text. I will specify that it's a top sale product. Copy and paste this text 3 times inside the layer. Make sure that the text layer is aligned both to the left and center relative to the card, as demonstrated. Select the text layer and click Add under Step-by-Step Animation. Here, under Event, select Block on Screen. It means that the animation starts immediately once the block appears on the screen. After that, enable the looping and add the first step. Set the duration to 30 seconds and adjust the offset. You can enter the coordinates manually, but it will be easier to simply move the layer to the left. While holding the Shift key, drag the layer to align the last duplicated text with the position of the first one. We have set up the animation so that in 30 seconds, the text will move all the way to the left and then loop, starting a new cycle. By holding down the Shift key, we move the text only along one axis. Now let's go back to the layer settings. In the Pointer Events field, choose None. The setting makes the layer non-clickable, which prevents users from accidentally selecting the text instead of following the link. Let's take another look at the layout. For the effect to work properly, make sure each product image has its background removed, is saved in PNG format, and is placed on a separate layer. Drag and drop the product images into zero block, then place them in the center of the product card. Add other design elements and make sure the image layers are placed on top. Done! Will the effect work on mobile devices? Absolutely! We can create various animations for the mobile version that are not triggered by mouse movement. In other words, you cannot create mobile animation on hover because we use touchscreen on mobile devices. Let's see how we can adapt it to fit other screen resolutions. Since I use auto scale, I didn't add additional breakpoints, for example, for a 1920 pixel resolution. Auto scale automatically adjusts the block for any screen width. For resolutions between 960 and 1200 pixels, I have made the product card smaller and reduced the text spacing so they fit on the screen. I have also decreased the new sticker text to 150. Don't forget to enable animation by clicking the switch on button. After that, you can adjust the values of each animation step so they display correctly across different screen resolutions. Since we have decreased the font size, we need to adjust the position on the x-axis in the first step. For devices with a resolution of 640 to 960 pixels, like tablets, I have rearranged the product cards so that they are placed one under the other. For resolutions between 480 and 640 pixels, I only aligned the cards to the center but kept the size of the elements unchanged. And finally, for the mobile version, I made the product card smaller, reduced the padding, and set the font size to 15 pixels. Additionally, I decreased the new sticker text to 100 pixels and adjusted the x-axis accordingly. Let's check it out. Great, it works perfectly. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe for more content, and share your thoughts in the comments. Don't forget to check out the description for the project template. Bye!